Welcome back, guys, to episode 48 of Let's Play Enderman. And yes, this episode continuing off from last with our new EnderCity. Oh yes. Now, we're gonna go over there and have a whole bunch of materials, and we're gonna begin building one of the buildings over there. And in that circle or chunk of our village, we're gonna have enchanting and a library in one building, portals and warps in one building, beds and spare space in another building, and the last one is gonna be the villagers, but I'm not really gonna do that until we have all four chunks built. So what we're gonna work this episode on is enchanting and library and portals room. So I think they have some contrast since usually people make like nether portals look like the nether and stuff like that. We're gonna switch it up a bit and we're gonna make the portal room out of sandstone just to have some contrast with the portal and everything. And then the library, we're gonna use nether bricks and some of these other materials that I'm bringing along. See how we can mix it up and make it look good. And ooh, there's a lot of mobs down there. So yeah. Okay, now the villagers, I think I'm gonna want them in this building. Load this building. This one over here. And the beds, we'll probably have them in the building right across from that. And then one will be portals and one will be library and stuff. So the one thing I'm missing is my enchanting table from the village, so we're gonna have to teleport there and ouch. Okay, so this is one of the last teleports you're gonna have to doodle here, and then we'll never be back again. Oh, and I also should take that. That's also something I need to do. And it should be 48 now, so just for the sake of perfection and completion and other shun, we'll have it 48. Episode 48, and that's probably gonna be the last time you see this, and I'm gonna tear it down and maybe we'll build something like it in our new place. So alright, I wonder if Silk Touch picks up bookshelves. Probably does. Whoops. Hello, villager. What are you doing today? I'm gonna trade you out. You suck. Go to hell. And yeah, I'm not gonna tear down this village. All I'm taking is just the important stuff. So that's a lot of stuff he's got. This is Jack and Say, which is also playing on my server now. He'd better move his shit out of there soon, because I don't like it. I'm not going to bother moving this entire portal tower thingy. So let's teleport back. I really don't like using teleport, but it's the only way that we can really travel 4,000 blocks. And here we are. Welcome back. Okay, we don't need books. Let's go over there. And we'll begin building our library slash enchanting room. Okay, so this is gonna be our new building. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep these lamps or replace them. So, the floor, I really want to make it nether brick. But first of all, I think we need to figure out where we need to put the bookshelves and where our enchanting table needs to go. We're probably gonna use more than one enchanting table, so I'm gonna have to make a few more. And yes, it would be a waste of diamonds, but I just want it like that. And we can also probably make different enchanting tables with different levels. So if you have like 24 levels, you can go to one. If you have only 10 levels, you can go to another table. And they'll have different amounts of bookshelves around them. So let's make this. I'll probably start by putting bookshelves along this wall. And then we'll put paintings or windows here. Start with this. I wonder if that locks out. Well, we'll put new lighting in, so that doesn't matter. Maybe pumpkins in the floor or something to stick with the old village of nether brick, and jack-o'-lanterns look very nice together with the orange and purple or red, whatever it is. Darkish maroon. And ooh, that takes a lot of bookshelves. Don't like using a lot of bookshelves because it wastes a lot of wood. Okay. All the floor, we're gonna replace it with this. But first of all, I wanna put like bookshelves in the center as well. So maybe if we put like, I feel like I'm missing something. How would this be? How many levels would we get on something? And I don't have anything that's not enchanted. How stupid is that? Ugh. Alright, we'll have to test that later. Put the tables down later. And yeah, this is kind of complicated because this isn't the standard shape and I'm not completely sure of what I want. Okay, let's try paintings. I don't want to put bookshelves on every wall because then that just makes it look ridiculous. Let's try to get large paintings. Large. No big paintings. Oh, here. Well, this is too boring. I'm gonna pause for a while until I get the stuff ready. Alright guys, I actually changed my mind and I'm not going to even try putting a floor made out of that. So instead we're going to be making other stuff. And I think I forgot for obsidian. Oh god. Can't remember how to make the stuff. I haven't made an enchanting table for a very long time actually. Alright, so instead, we're just gonna put a bunch of enchanting tables and bookshelves and paintings on them. So, oops, fail. So I think that's gonna be enough with 4 enchanting tables. Now let's just hop over there and we're gonna find certain places to put them that we can get different types of levels. So, the enchanting tables are probably going to be on the same floor, and on the bottom floor we'll probably just have the bookshelves with the written books and the books you can write in down there, the stories or whatever the hell we want to put in. Okay, let's try an enchanting table right here. Max level is 12. Alright, and we want the same on the opposite side. And then we'll also put an enchanting table somewhere over here. Well, there's gonna be one in the center. It's gonna be the main one, and it's gonna be fully covered. So it's gonna have to be like this. And that will probably, oh, only 28, 29. Yeah, so we need one more bookshelf here. And since it's odd, we can't do that, but I think it still works if you put the additional levels. 30, awesome. It works perfectly. And over here, I'll probably fill this space up with something, I don't know what yet. Glowstone, right, I wanted to put new lighting in. You probably can instead just take out the books that are blocking the light, and do the same on the other side, just to make it a bit brighter and we don't have to add in extra blocks. There we go. Much nicer. Now the last two are sort of going to be in between the 12 and 30, probably around 20, 24 levels. 24 is probably the best because it would be the level we can get the feather falling boots. This one's 12. And if we add more bookshelves, I think it's too close to that one. I want to move it down a bit. And I'll probably have to use more bookshelves. So this one is not in line with that one. Here or here? Or here? Let's try here for now. No, actually we should move it further forward so that they're not all squished towards the wall. And this one, how many blocks is it? Wait. 1, 2 from the corner. Perfect. Now we just need to try to get 24 by placing the correct bookshelves around it. Let's try that. 16. 20. Mm-hmm. 24. Awesome. Okay, we have the perfect configuration right there. Three this way, three that way, and two. Doesn't look very nice, but I'm going to try to modify it to make it look nice and a bit better than what it is right now. Now, this one we have over here. Let's try to, instead of having these that go around this way, if we can put them on those two sides and get rid of some of these, that would make it more open and still get the top level 30, which is what we want. I think that way is pretty good. The places back here, we're probably gonna light up with a torch and cover up just to make it lit from behind, looking a bit nicer, but still I don't want to see all these spaces behind the bookshelves and stuff like that. Problem is that these will get affected too if we put them too close. So what we probably want is just to block off this entire area over here. Maybe by I think that's gonna have to do for now, because I just don't have any other ideas of what to do. And that looks pretty good with all the enchanting tables out in the open like that. This is still 24. This one's still 30. And now we're gonna have to try to keep this one lower, because you can still get one with this. And we don't, if we have like a cheap tool and we don't want to enchant it, if you put bookshelves here, that one's gonna get affected. And we want to block this off so we don't see it. So, because I don't think we can put a block inside of that. Maybe if we move it forward a little, and we won't have the bookshelves on the back affecting it. It's only to level 10. Oh, whoa. 15? Oh yeah, I can still change. Okay. But what I want to do exactly is do that. Not be able to see those spaces that we have behind here. Like that. I think that looks pretty good, except this will now have a much higher level. 18. Well, you can still get the lower ones, and only like 3 or 2, so I guess that's pretty good. I think I'm gonna stick with that for now. And maybe put some bookshelves right here. Some bookshelves between the wall and the middle of the paths. And we're out of bookshelves. Okay. Sucks. Anyways, I guess we're gonna have to start working on the lower level afterwards. Well, once we get more bookshelves. But for now, we're gonna stop this and begin work on our portal room. So, I guess I'm gonna go get more supplies, and I'll see you guys there. Okay, what turns out is amazing is that we only have 14 obsidian left, which is only enough for one portal. But I guess we're gonna have to do with that, and maybe go mining in Nether another day. I mean, in the end. So, let's get to it. Well, I have it planned out, but I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna do once we have enough obsidian, obviously. And this is... Okay, this is the design I want to do with the quad portals here, and I'm not sure if I'm going to extend it so it's diagonal, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, or 1. Alright, so, or we could just do a 4x4 square, which would be a lot simpler, but would not fill the entire room. And what I wanted is something that would kind of fill the entire space that we have in here. Another option also is to make one of those warp tunnels, which would be just portal in front of a portal in front of a portal. And it would sort of go into the side, so there would be one here. I really don't want to put the obsidian blocks on the sides of the walls because it shows on the outside and that would kind of wreck the look of the buildings, so it's not something that I'm really happy about. I'm gonna have to have all these pillars on the inside. We can put like this. Obviously, these cobblestone blocks would be obsidian blocks, but they would be in the ground, one block lower, so it's not have to jump up and down or anything. And then you just have like a tunnel of portals from the door all the way to there, and same on the other side. That could also be something we're gonna do. But if we do that style portal, that's just one in the center or something. But since this is triangular, I'm not really sure how I could put that in the center, because it wouldn't be straight. And that's also gonna be one of our problems, figuring out how to place the portal. But for now, I just really want to get to explore the Nether and begin building stuff. Well, actually, I'm not sure if I'm going to begin or if I'm going to wait till 1.4, because that's they might put spawners for the new mobs, and we would need to reset the Nether again, which would be a waste of work. So, gonna put the first one here, and eventually we'll extend it down this way and down that side too, and probably put something in the middle. But for now, this is all we're gonna do. So I have to get rid of this glowstone lamp. And how am I gonna do this? Ouch. Oh, this is gonna hurt too, isn't it? It's gonna take at least 2.5 hearts health. Oh, I should have planned this better. And I need to get the food going, so we're probably just gonna finish the library portal room. Ah! Stupid creepers. Finish the library, as I was saying, portal room, and the beds building and the villagers building, I'm just gonna leave. I don't care. I'll probably just stick a bed in one of those. And the villagers will be our last project. So let's see if this kills us. Yes, it does. Darn it! Alright, that was a stupid idea. We better bring more food. I also lost 24 levels, my god. Bring more food, more food. Really running low on steak. I'm gonna have to get my cow farm up and running. Alright, well, the good thing is that everything in this new Ender City is pretty close to each other, so it's not like we've lost anything. Oh wait, there was a cactus right there. Oh crap. Ooh, crap. Where was it? There was a hole in the ceiling. There it is. There's all our stuff. Oh, and a creeper. And I have got nothing. I have nothing. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh god. Alright, I think they're far enough away. Let's try to get our stuff. Yes, I got the arrows. Cool pellet mobs. Yes, that's right. I own you bad. You too. I hate you. Alright, well, we might as well take all the stuff for me. Probably missing something. Swords, picks, torches, bow, arrows, food, cobblestone, pearls, sticks, coal, obsidian. I think we have everything we need. Most of it, I think. Having fun in there. Little pool. Kitty pool. Alright. Stick that cactus back there. And instead of committing suicide again, this time we're actually gonna go like that. Much smarter. Alright. Let's continue from where we left off abruptly. Quite abruptly, actually. And get lost in all these buildings. Obsidian. Those light glitches won't go away. I wonder why. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, and the problem with using the portals is that there's also going to be obsidian showing upstairs, but I guess we can't really do much about that. And oh my gosh, I'm doing this in the wrong building. Oh man, this is the wrong building. This is where we have our library. Wow. Okay. Let me just do this alone then. Okay. There it is. First portal in our new Ender City. And it looks kind of fat. But there's nothing we can do about that. It would be actually really cool if we could change the shape of portals. And then the portal blocks on the inside, we could make like a 3x3 portal or a 1x2 portal. But yeah, let's take a look and be prepared for what you might see, because I haven't done this yet. So, what do we have? Ooh, nice glowstone here. Very nice. And what's up this way? More glowstone. Oh yes, that's nice. That's nice, I like that. Good area, nice flat area. We could build a base over here. Or a minecart station or whatever. But let's see if we get any nether fortresses to spawn close by, because we really need one of those instead of traveling too far to find one. Ooh, a nice soul sand over there we can mine. Don't see anything in that direction. Just getting kinda laggy. I'm gonna try a new trick. F3A. I like all this glowstone though that we have very near to us. Cause we're gonna do the rails anyways to another fortress. It's just that I want it a bit closer than usual. Well, just a bit closer so it's easier to get to. Where did our portal go? I'm lost. Good thing I'm recording in case it gets seriously lost. I can always teleport back to wherever we were. And oh, there's that guest. Don't go that way. Don't go that way. I came from over here, so. Yes, there was that soul sand. And we were. Oh, that was close. Came from over there, I think. Yes, there's our portal. Let's check the other side, see if we find anything, and maybe later I will do a bit more exploring on my own, just to not bore you guys with the lag, and with, I guess, if I don't find anything, which usually sometimes it takes quite a long time to find something interesting in the nether. But what is this? A tunnel? Cave? Hole? Hole. Okay, I'm gonna go searching in this direction. I should actually put markers in case I get lost. Let's go up this way, and if we don't find anything, we'll go back. I'm afraid this is getting a bit too boring, probably, for you guys. Whoops. Big cavern over here. Also don't want to get lost. Okay. Over this way there was nothing, wasn't there? Sounds like lots of guests actually. Well, there's lots of glowstone, which is very nice, and it's gonna come in quite useful actually. Probably gonna need it for future projects and stuff like that. Just in case, we should get ender pearls ready. That looks like it would be a very good place to find a strong, nether fortress, but I'm not completely sure if it would be that easy. Marker just in case. Let's teleport over there. And see if we see anything. Whoops, lag. No, here there's definitely nothing. But take a look from there. Oh, ghast. And nothing over there except for our ghast. Let's teleport back. Just want to be very careful. There's no holes that go down to lava. And what can we see from here? Very interesting, but no nether fortress close by. Oh, is this gonna fall? No, it's not. Very dangerous. Well, we'll search around this place another time, and if I find something, I'll probably record it. Last episode was kind of long, even though it was like very short clips, like 1 or 2 minutes here and there. And they added up to a lot, so I'm gonna try to keep this episode down. Probably gonna have to get a bit more bookshelves and a bit more obsidian, and then we'll probably be able to continue. Because it's gonna be kind of hard. Oh, we came from there? Or can we go back this way? Oh, well. Glowstone. And I'm guessing with my awesome sense of direction. Whoa, that's a very nice clump of glowstone over there. I think it's inside, though. We're just seeing this through a glitch. Yes, it's not loading. But we know there's something over there. Maybe we should go see if there's, we can mark it. In case we don't know it. Or we don't see it another time. Oh, yes. I like this glowstone. Very nice when we have this glowstone that's not hanging over lava. Very easy to get. And it's plentiful. Awesome. Okay, I'm not sure if we're going to build the rail system yet, or if we're going to wait till 1.3, 1.4 for the new mobs, because if there are new mobs, we're going to have to reset the nether, because the wither skeletons and withers are going to be in the nether, so I'm not really excited to build, awesome, it goes back to the same place, I'm not really excited to build a complex thing in the nether and have to reset it just to get the new mobs, and the new mobs are the only way to get those beacons, which we really want. You want lots of those. So, yeah, it's kind of, we're gonna have to wait a while until we can actually get a decent transport system to and from each place, because I think 1.4 is gonna come out sometime next year. Which is a long time. And yeah. It's very difficult to MC edit stuff in and out of the nether too. Because of all those weird generations. But anyways, I'll talk to Scapegoat and friends and see what they think about it. And then probably make a decision based on that. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave right now. You can hear a creeper below. Tools and items. And I'm gonna put the stuff away, probably go mining a bit, do something else, and once I have enough bookshelves or glowstone, I mean obsidian, then I'll be able to record more. So bye for now. Well, another thing that I also do in my spare time that is very productive, but I can't record, is my iron golem farm, which I do over here. And I usually just sit AFK here, wait for for the iron golems to pile up and then kill them all. But I've decided that I wanted to also do something aside from being AFK when I don't have much to do and I need iron. I decided that I would bring a bunch of gravel over here, and I can actually use my time to waste these useless shovels that I got when I was trying to get silk pit shovels. And I've used them pretty good. Most of them are either efficiency or fortune. The good ones, which are efficiency and unbreaking, or all three with fortune, I save. But useless ones, I use efficiency to cut back this. I'm going to begin using efficiency to clear out this entire area and make it all flat and make a huge ice farm, which will be a future project as well. Or I can use my spare time to use a fortune shovel to dig up some of this piles of gravel that I have stored over there. And actually mining out all this dirt is actually also filling up quite a few chests of dirt, which is also useless. But anyways, all the gravel I get, I save it, so here I can just use a fortune 3 shovel and turn it all into flint, which will be useful later. And they might actually add something in the game that this becomes a bit more useful than just flint and steel. And arrows. That too. But yeah. So that's what I do in my spare time. And dig all this up. Get lots of flint. And I'm also gonna go sometime to the Enderman processor. Our Enderman farm to get a bit more more shovels, enchant a few more so I have more to do stuff around here, and I have also a chance to get more silk touch shovels, which we will eventually need when we have our grass and mycelium farm set up in our new Ender City. It's really funny as well, as sometimes you can see all their heads popping down as they go through there, but it seems like there wasn't much this time. So yeah, gravel transformation into flint, dirt removal, and iron farming is what I'm gonna be doing, along with also some mining and other stuff. So this is very nice. Oh yes, and it says lol. I'm probably gonna fill this up. I wonder how much it actually is, because you can't really tell when it's like that. About half a chest. So yeah, that's what I also do in some of my spare time. Hey guys, right now I am actually putting switches on the underside of the redstone lamps, and slowly, little by little, we're getting enough iron to start getting this third circle ready to be built with stone. And that's something I want to do as soon as possible, because we really need to get our farms going. And I don't want to use one more stack of stake. Well, I'm going to try to finish all this with this and one more stack of stake, and see if that's possible, because I don't want to keep wasting food without having a way to replenish it. Since right now we have no farms up, and yeah. So right now we have those two already built. I just need to continue putting the stuff in that one. And yeah, so what we're going to do right now, once I finish placing a few more of these, I'm not sure how many I need actually. 9, 6. And yeah, this is getting ready to build the third chunk, and it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. And yeah. There's this little patch of rain over here that's separated from the rest. It's not here. It rains here. Really funny how that stuff works in Minecraft. But anyways, okay, so a few more searches, and now we're did mine obsidian. Went to the end and took down one of those huge obsidian towers, and got a couple stacks of obsidian from that, which I think should be enough for several portals at least. So that's what we're gonna go do right now. And after that, I might go exploring a bit, see if we find anything new. But I'm not gonna record it, because usually it takes a long time to find something, and it would just be very boring to watch. So, yeah, let's go get the obsidian that we need, and flint and steel. And I'm gonna go, I'm gonna begin to build the portals. And I'll see what design I like best. I'm not completely sure yet, but I'll figure it out. I also went caving today. Lit up a lot of caves. That was a big mine shaft, and lots of cool stuff around this big desert. So, ouch. There's seeds down here. Well, now that we have seeds, we might as well put them away. And, Kekken Say, which was also a player that's on my server, I think it was yesterday or a few days ago, he asked me, well, I told him that I save every block that we have, that I get. And he's like, why'd you say that? You're not gonna need it. And, well, in the updates, more and more stuff is becoming useful. And in the last update preview, seeds were actually used for breeding chickens. So, some of the most useless stuff that it seems actually turns out to be really useful in the future. So that's why anything I get, even if it's rotten flesh, I save it. And someday it's going to be used. Maybe I should start eating rotten flesh instead of beef. That could save some food. But yeah, what else do we need? Let's see. Pickaxes, we need flint and steel. And there we go. Already have one. Oh, I'll finish this one right. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and begin building them, and I guess I'll see you guys when it's done. In case you're wondering, you can't put portals one right in front of the other. You have to have actually one block space between portals. So, yeah, you have to do it like this, because it doesn't allow you to light the portals if they're too close. And, yeah, can't see anything from here. And it's not the most pretty sight, but I might actually fill in these blocks here that don't have a portal in something. Maybe end stone, just to give it a nice black and white look. I think that would look pretty cool. And yeah, so next side. All right, guys, this is what it looks like right now and for now. And I'm not sure what we're gonna add in this empty space over here. Might put something else that's got to do with portals. Too bad we can't move end portals. But yeah, this is it for now. We got all our portals set up, and it actually, the design on the top floor, it actually doesn't look that bad. I thought it would be worse, but since it's just lines, I think it looks pretty good. Not horrendous or anything. Okay. Another thing we could also do is put a second portal right beside them, which would be like 1, 2, 3. Would be another row of portals here, or pretend these blocks are obsidian. And then we'll just create another tunnel right beside it. And we'd have like an empty space over here that we wouldn't use for anything. That could also work. Or we could just leave it empty until we decide, and obviously we don't have enough obsidian to do that, so I'm gonna just wait. Alright. So, what I'm going to do right now, is now that we have our portal room up and running, I'm gonna go back to our base over there, and drop off all my stuff so that I can go to the nether, explore a bit, and not be worried about losing any of the important stuff I've got on me. So, yeah, gotta be prepared. Let's see. Some steel. Just leave this one here. Take this one just in case. Bow and arrows we can take. It's a bad bow, it doesn't really matter. And yeah, I think that's all we need to drop from that side. Here. Coal. Sticks. I think we can take ender pearls and just a bit of meat. This goes in the other building. Alright, that's what I'm gonna be taking with me. And wish me luck, I hope I don't die, and let's hope to find armor I can take anyways. Let's hope to find another fortress. Aha! After several times of dying and several tries of success, I think that we have finally succeeded. And aha! Yes! A nether fortress. And our portal is at coordinates 0, 500. So this is like 500 blocks away, but it's the closest one I could find. And I think we could extend out a path out of right over there. And just to be safe, I'm gonna try to end a pearl there. And this might kill us. Let's hope it doesn't. Okay, awesome. Ta-cha! Nether Fortress. Yes, we have found you, Mr. Nether Fortress. Let's go take a look around here, and probably end the episode with that. Nice ending. Finding a new Nether Fortress, yes, yes, yes. Alright, let's go check out what we got. I'm not totally convinced of making the rails in the nether yet because of the update 1.4, which is in more than a year, but it would mean that we would have to redo everything because I want to reset the nether for 1.4. So yeah, it's gonna be inconvenient. I think the best we can do is make pathways. Like, instead of putting rails down, just make a path that we can follow easily to and from each place. And load already. There we go. Alright, seems like we got lots of lava falling from the ceiling, which is extremely annoying and also hard to get around. So let's try to block it off as best we can. Uh-oh, that's bad. That was a bad idea. Oh, never mind there. All solved. Ah! Oh god. Don't die. Okay. Gotta be safe. I think that should work. That was scary. Oh, man. Alright. Let's check out this direction first. Got some mushrooms. Very nice. I might want to take these back. Not that it's really necessary. I'm gonna make a mushroom farm too. But just to clean the fortress up a little. Nothing on this end. This isn't really nether music, is it? They should change. Oh my goodness. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is. Oh my goodness. This is just ridiculous. Where'd all this come from? Happens to fall and goes all over the place where we need to explore. Well, I'm gonna let that try to run out for a little, because I don't think we can really do much from here now, can we? We'd have to go up there to try to fix it. Let's try to ender pearl to there. Okay, so this place ends here. There's a main part of this awesome fortress. Oh god, I'm dying. No! No! Well, that took a long time. I had to walk all the way back here, get my stuff. Lost my armor. Oh yes. And my skin's all black now. That's something I forgot to mention at the beginning of the episode. But now I don't even have eyes. Instead of colored eyes, black eyes. Oh yes. Camouflage in the night. So, yeah. I also took a bit of time to bucket off the ceiling, and I'm hoping that it will eventually go away. I'm not sure if it does in the nether. But yeah, in the meantime, let's go exploring a little. I think, is that a dead end or is that glowstone in the way? But does it continue? That is the question. No, it does not continue. Oh well. Whoa, that's a huge bunch of glowstone over there. Wow, that's gonna be nice. Alright, let's see what we got. Oh, blaze. And I don't even have a sword or armor. Where? Oh, darn it. Stupid blaze. Here is the underground part of the stronghold. And there's another blaze spawner. This is a dead end. Where does this go? Don't seem to see any nether warp, but it's not like we need any. Oh! Back here again. Let's check if there was another way that we could go. Aside from... beside those... No, it looks all cut off. Not much underground sections of this, is there? Ow. 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 Oh. Those guys are dangerous. Wow. No, there's no other way. Well, there's actually two over here, so let's see if this is gonna be dangerous. Can we make it? Yes, we can. Lava. There was this other place over here. We came in that way. And there's this other one that... Oh, I see. This is the underground part of the nether fortress. Oh, yes. Oh. Here's the connection. This lava dot marks the entrance from outside the outside fortress into the inner fortress. Inside the walls. Very nice. Oh, yes. I really like nether fortresses because they're a great source of a very nice block. And they look really cool, too. Well, that's a dead end. This continues. Nothing that way. Another dead end. This goes down. Goes off nothingness, nothingness, and nothingness. Let's see what's upstairs. We came in this way. Won't go that way. Oh, there's Blazer. Oh boy. Sounds like a lot of blaze, man. Oh, here's another place. This one seems like a dead end. I'm not gonna take the nether warts. I'm probably just gonna leave them here since we have enough. Well, we have enough to make a farm in Overworld. And we have quite a few stacks, so it's not like... It's very important to take these. Another dead end. Oh, those blaze are scaring me. Hello. I don't have a sword, so I can't deal with them right now. This is also a dead end, and the fortress continues that way, so I think maybe next episode or the one after we will have a little trip to here. Make a blaze farm, maybe. And explore the last section of that. So... Now we have to go over there, and it's going to be very dangerous, as we can't cross this way because it's full of lava. I can't ender pearl there because I'm going to miss and I'm going to fall in lava, that's for sure. Only option is to attempt to go around. Lava is still going, isn't it? That seems like it's gone. Okay, we'll have to set up a easy way to get over here instead of having to jump all over the place with ender pearls. Make a path all the way to our portal, and then we'll be back next time. Oh. Blaze spawner here. Maybe that's where the blaze were. No, they were at the top upstairs. Oh, there they are. Alright. I'm not going there right now. Goodbye, guys. And yeah, I'm gonna end the episode here. Thanks for watching. And see you guys next time, where we will commence our farms and finish up the chunk number 2, the second circle, which is half done, I think. And that's about it. So see you guys next time.